In cosmology, the Hubble constant is constantly debated. But what is it, and why does it matter? In general, it's an incredibly important number because it determines so much of what we know about the universe, including its age, history, and future. And yet, it's a figure that's also troublesome and mysterious. It's hard to get an exact value for it, and it's at the crux of one of science's toughest problems. Now, though, we might have made a breakthrough with it, and it takes us into a phantom mirror world. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, did scientists just uncover the secret mirror universe that holds reality together? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. We start almost 100 years ago. In the early 20th century, when astronomers began working with all new technology, the basic concept of even multiple galaxies was still way off. To most minds back then, our galaxy, the Milky Way, was also the entire universe, containing every single star, planet, and object. In the 1920s, however, the astronomer Edwin Hubble thought that there was probably something more, something else, to the bizarre, faint object he was looking at through his telescope. At the time, the object was generally thought to be nothing more than a nebula, but Hubble suggested that it looked more like an island universe. And as it turns out, it was the Andromeda Galaxy, the first galaxy ever found outside of our own. Over time, Hubble would go on to find and measure more galaxies, steadily building his legacy as one of the most influential astronomers of all time. Along the way, though, he discovered something further that again shocked scientists all around the world. Not only were there many other galaxies in the universe besides our own, but they were also moving away from us. And the farther away they were, the faster they were retreating. Of course, we now understand that this is because the universe is expanding, while the rate of that expansion is what's come to be known as the Hubble constant. From there, though, it's not exactly straightforward. Hubble's initial measure of this constant worked out as 501 kilometers per second per megaparsec. But ultimately, this figure also stands as the first example of just how difficult it is to measure the constant with accuracy. Because Hubble, it seems, was way off, with his number being at least 10 times higher than most modern estimations. It gets still more confusing, though, because despite the name, it turns out that the number isn't actually a constant at all. Thanks to laws set out by what are known as the Friedman equations, we know that the rate of expansion of the universe simply can't stay the same. That it all depends on the density of matter and energy in the universe, which all changes with expansion. It's some heavy math, but it essentially means that the Hubble constant, the expansion rate of the universe, is always updating and fixing itself. It never actually stands still. And then there's yet one final major sticking point in the story of the Hubble constant, the Hubble tension. This refers to how the constant, a number that's ever-changing anyway, also changes depending on how it's measured. There are a variety of methods used, but they don't all arrive at the same number. They generally fall somewhere between 65 and 75 kilometers per second per megaparsec. Again, it's a range that's comfortably lower than Hubble's initial conclusion, but there is, at present, no single agreed-upon value. This discrepancy, this tension, is not then easily resolved. No one seems to know why the numbers don't match up. And that's a big problem if we're ever trying to show how the universe really works. But that could be about to change. In a contemporary multi-authored study published in May 2022 in the journal Physical Review Letters, aims to resolve the Hubble tension once and for all by predicting the existence of a mirror world that exists alongside of our own. This mirror world, if it is there, is an exact copy of ours but is invisible, and the only interactions it has with us are through gravity. In the proposed world, every particle that exists in our world may have a mirror opposite, and it's as though there's a point of overlap between here and there, which could serve to settle the Hubble tension and therefore finally explain why our universe is like it is. In a statement, those behind the study explain that their research involves applying scaling symmetry to the universe. They note that a lot of the observations we do in cosmology have an inherent symmetry, so there is precedent for this approach. However, in this case, for the scaled symmetry to stick and keep sticking, it was found that there had to be another separate mirror dimension out there somewhere beyond our own, but still exerting a gravitational force upon our universe. As to what the mirror dimension could be made of, the leading theory says dark matter. Dark matter has before been used to explain seemingly missing mass in our universe, an unknown something that apparently has an impact on our galaxy. And so this could be the latest extension of that, which is exciting because it potentially means that the mirror model could actually solve two of the biggest problems in cosmology if it's correct: the Hubble tension and the true nature of dark matter. What's perhaps a little surprising, then, is that the general idea of a mirror world or phantom plane isn't actually new. It can, in general, be traced back to at least the 1990s, but it's only now been applied for the first time to also solve the Hubble tension. Similarly, research in 2018 theorized the existence of a mirror world as well, although instead of it being one that dealt with gravity, it was instead built around the function of time. Here it was suggested that a mirror universe might have existed before the Big Bang, from which point it moved backwards in time, perfectly reflecting our own experience of time moving forward. This model and the more recent mirror theory are not related, but they perhaps do share some similarities in terms of how they make us feel in the here and now. Because in whatever form it takes, if there is a mirror world out there, then naturally the next questions are, what's it like there? And could we ever break into it? Without effectively turning ourselves inside out, either physically or temporally, it seems unlikely that we ourselves would ever be able to travel through such a place. But there have been various predictions made as to how a mirror world might work. If there are reflected copies of every known particle there, for example, from our perspective, then it could be that it's a realm that's extremely similar to our own. We might think of the elements, objects, and life forms that live there, though, as dark versions of what we know. In science fiction, this idea is often used to imply an evil or volatile state. But really, the darkness is more a reference to the fact that everything on the other side can't be seen. It's hidden, secret, and ultra-mysterious. And who knows, if all of that does exist, then might those dark life forms in their dark reality also be thinking about, predicting, and attempting to study us in return? To them, are we a hidden but theorized world waiting to be discovered? Are there problems in their own physics that only make sense if another world is realized? For now, the implications aren't yet quite so fantastic as that. But still, this latest research does offer a promising potential solution to the Hubble tension. It's not the finished article, and there are sure to be follow-up investigations to try and more fully figure out this especially tricky aspect of the universe. For one, NASA will soon launch the Nancy Grace Roman Space Telescope, which is set to become a crucial flagship facility in our quest to better understand the universe's rate of expansion, the Hubble constant, the most distant objects away from us, and if, how, and where dark matter comes into the equation. And, as with so many of science's open questions about space, we might expect the freshly launched James Webb Space Telescope to contribute some answers too. Until we gain an even clearer idea, then, we can spend some time simply pondering the phantom, reflected world that might be out there, where particles perhaps converge in such a way that even your very own life experience is played out again but different. It might feel a little strange, but it could also be vitally important, because that's how scientists may have just discovered a secret mirror universe that holds reality together. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.